Hi everybody, I'm Stefano.
And I'm Sasha. We are gypsies on the road, and this is our self-converted shuttle bus.
It's a 2003 Ford E450 with a 6.8 liter gas engine.
We bought it as a church bus, did a full conversion in 90 days.
Welcome to our bus. I'll show you around to give you a little tour. First up, we have our entryway. We have our half entry wall, which was one of the first things we built, and we love it for a little bit of storage. We have a little entry shelf for things that we need to grab before we leave the bus, and then we have a little couple of shelves storage in here. The top shelf we use for just extra toiletries, sunscreen and stuff, and the bottom shelf is our little workout gear shelf. And then we have a shoe rack here slash plant rack. We wanted to maximize this space here by putting something here, and we're super happy with that. The dash we just left as it is due to our time crunch. And above the dash, we store a lot of our tools and things to get us out if we're stuck, and all the boring kind of car stuff goes. Behind the driver's seat, we have our bathroom, essentially. Our toilet is behind a curtain and runs along a little drawer and comes out and in. We also have a curtain that runs across the dash here so that we can put that on either side of the toilet when we use it, which is really handy if we're trying to use it in a public space. Above that, we keep our drinking water. In Mexico, it's really handy to have this 5-gallon bottle of water with our electric pump. We've got our towels, toiletries, and we left some full-length storage behind the toilet. We store our vacuum, our broom, our beach umbrella, kind of bigger stuff there, which is super handy. And then our shower is just behind our toilet. This is one of our favorite parts of the build. We feel super lucky to be able to have a hot shower at night, and we are thrilled with it. It was one of the last things that we built. We were really afraid about it, but it actually was not that difficult. We did all of the plumbing, all of the waterproofing, everything ourselves. Stefano built an awesome little shelf for our toiletries as well, so they don't move around while we drive. And it's a really big, nice size. I think it's about 32 by 24, which is perfect. Next to our shower, we have our dining table with our bench seats. We built this here because we have this handicap door here, and we wanted to really maximize the use of this space while still being able to access these doors. We love to sit down here and throw the doors open so we can kind of be eating in nature. This table we found on Facebook Marketplace and cut it to the perfect size, and it drops down to become a day bed or a single bed. We custom made these bench cushions to fit perfectly, so I'll show you how we set that up. The main feature of our bus, and really the only reason that we bought a bus, is for our surfboard so that we could drive around and go surfing. We have longboards, so we have 2 9-foot boards, and we needed to be able to keep them inside the bus so that they're safe. So we designed the entire layout of the bus around being able to fit our 2 surfboards inside. We love that they're here because they're out of the way. When you sit down at the table, there's plenty of space. We have only hit our head on them maybe one time walking through the bus, and Stefano designed this surf rack for them, which has held up really well. So we are super happy that we could fit these inside, and it still feels spacious enough as well with them. This little section is our mini fridge. This is a normal house mini fridge, so it runs on AC power. And we love that the color matches our kitchen, and we also love that we have a freezer as well. On top of the fridge, we put a bookshelf. This was a non-negotiable for me to have a bookshelf, and we're super happy we put it here because it keeps kind of the windows above this fridge really open. We wanted to keep as many windows open as we could to keep it nice and bright in here. And then Stefano built me a closet. We made a little barn style door for the front, and we used the closet for some hanging space. We've got a mirror inside and some storage in some shelves and below. It's a great size for the both of us. And then on the other side of the bus, we have our beautiful kitchen. We have been obsessed with our kitchen from the start. We love the colors, we love the rattan cabinets, we love how open and kind of clean it looks and how much bench space we have. So we're super happy with this. We went with all kind of black features throughout the bus as well. So we matched the sink to the stove and to other parts of the bus too. We bought these cabinets pre-built, and this kind of pantry area we made ourselves. We have a lot of pantry space, which is really important to us because we want to be off-grid for like all the time, as long as possible. So we've got two big pantry drawers, and we also have a pull-out pantry, which was also something that was really important to us, where we keep all our kind of canned goods and spices. This little shelf above the pantry is handy to keep things like our chargers and anything we need to store next to the bed. We also have a little kind of opening here where we've got a plant. We keep our kitchen goods in these two cabinets overhead. They run on hinges and they stay up, which is really handy. And that is plenty of space for cups and plates and coffee machine and things like that. And then this cabinet is just kind of random things. I keep my toiletries here. We keep our hoard of almond and alternative milks here for our morning lattes. And then the rest of the overhead cabinets are for our clothing. On this side of our kitchen, we have our sink and our stove. Underneath the stove, we have a propane tank. This runs on propane, and we have two burners. And then underneath the sink, we have a water filter. We do already buy filtered water in Mexico, but we have another water filter as well under there. And we have switches for overhead cabinetry lighting here, as well as our water pump, which is located underneath our bed. The sink has two functions, and the head pulls out, which we love, so that we could pull it out the window in case we need to have a shower after a surf or something like that. And all we've got left is our bedroom. We have a queen size bed at the back of the bus, and it lifts up on struts, and we have some storage underneath. Underneath we have a little cabinet, so we can open this up. And here we just keep right now in a basket like our jackets and sweaters and stuff. This is handy because sometimes it's annoying to have to lift the entire bed up if you just want to grab something. So we keep what we use every day down there. Over the bed is where we keep the rest of our clothes. This side is Stefano's and the other side is mine. I'm showing you Stefano's because it's really neat. This is half of his clothes. We find these little kind of shelves super handy as well. And Stefano let me paint the inside of the cabinets pink, which I'm really stoked about. They both lift up individually. And this one we keep some extra blankets and our laundry bag. And then in this one, I keep all of my yoga mats. I have an online yoga mat business, so I have a few with me to take photos and videos. And then we keep our insulated window coverings there. When you build a bus and you position your bed this way, there's always this awkward amount of space, like 10 inches at either the base or the head of the bed. So we decided to make this into more storage, and we added window struts to this back emergency exit window as well, so that we could keep it open. So we just pop it open when we're at the beach and we can hang out in bed and get the nice fresh air, which is amazing. We try to upcycle things as much as possible, and we tried to find used materials that we could use in the build. We were a little bit limited because we only had a 90-day build time frame for finding stuff, but we were really stoked to find this headboard for free on Facebook Marketplace. It was originally like this kind of gross gray color that we didn't like, but we sanded it and we love how it works with the rest of the bus. We have two switches for those main lights, one by the door and one by the bed, so we can control them from both, which was a electrician feat done by Stefano, and we're super happy we did that. And we also have USB charging ports so that we can charge our devices from bed. The bed was the first piece of furniture that we built, and we always knew that we wanted it to be able to lift up on struts because we have quite a bit of storage underneath there. So we built it on struts. So it stays up. We have our entire plumbing system underneath here. We have our freshwater tank, which is 45 gallons. We have our electric water heater for our warm showers, our water pump and water accumulator. And then the rest of this space is just storage. We have our beach chairs, some extra clothes, a whole bunch of tools because we're not quite done with the build yet. We're still doing some little touch-ups and some extra blankets and towels. We have a little ladder that we can pop just on the floor in front of the bed that allows us to step up through the emergency exit onto the roof. So this emergency exit pops all the way open and we can go sit up on the roof, watch the sunset, have drinks on the beach, which we love. I hope you enjoyed our bus tour. Let us know in the comments what you think and follow us along as we travel through Baja, Mexico for the next couple of months.